Hi, welcome all. Welcome to the session on user and group management from SNS Technical Training Institute. In this session, we'll look into the user and group management. How can we create users? How can we create groups? What are the different important configuration files? What are the different commands used? Different types of user? Let's take a deep dive. So there, as we already know, there are different types of users. So we have root user. And another is normal user. You have normal user. So root user, as you already know, is the most important user. He has the super access. So if you go and see the UID of the normal user is 0, and GUID is the group ID for this is 0, and the home directory for root user is slash root, and the cell is slash bin slash bash. And the normal user UID starts with 1000 to 60,000. It can be in any range. And group ID again starts from 1000 to 60,000, can be in any range. And the home address will be slash home and the name of the user which you have created, and the cell will be slash bin bash. So so this is something which you shouldn't remember. So if you want to see this, let me just show you this. Just by typing the command id, you will be able to see the UID of the root user is 0, GID of the root user is 0. So this is the same data which we were talking about. And for other normal users, it will be from 1000 to 60,000. So now let's see different types of user which are there present inside our operating system. So what is a user? A user is one who uses the system. So there can be different types of user. Once we have seen root user, another is normal user. The third type of user can be system user. So these are the users which are created by the system when you are installing some software like Apache, NFS, FTP. So when you create these users, they will be these users will be created. So their ID starts from 2201 to 999. So this is reserved for the system user. Then we have something called sudo user. Sudo users are someone who the normal user whom we have provided the root access. So if you provide a normal user with sudo access, so he will have the same access as the root user. The other types of user is network user. So network user is used for logging over the network. So whenever a user logs into your system over the network, then those types of user are called network user. So again, to reiterate, so different types of user: root user, then we have normal user, then we have system user, sudo user, and network user. So the root user SUID and GUID start from 00. The root is the home directory, bin bash is the shell where it will log. Normal user UID stand from 1000 to 60,000, and the GID will stand from 60,000 to 60,000. The home location will be slash home and the user ID, and bin bash is that cell. System users again created when you install your software, so their ID will start from 201 to 999. Sudo user are the same user as normal user, but they have the access similar to the root user. And then we have network user who can log in from network. Now we'll look into the different configuration files which are available and which you should know when you are working with users and group. So the first file will be your configuration file resides in etc config folder. So login.default. So this is one of the files which will have all the default values for your users and groups. So let's go and look into this file. So let's go and look into the login. So let's do a cat slash etc and login.defs definition. So So now let's see what are the things which are present inside this file. So this is a file which is used when you create a new user. So what will be the password aging for your new user will be picked up from this configuration. So the user will expire after 9999 days, and what should be the minimum password length, and when you should get the warning message when your password is going to expire. So you can make the configuration changes here, and whenever a new user is created, the same will be applied on it. So you can see the UID minimum 1000 to 60,000. So any normal user, it will the UID will start from 1000 and it can go up to 60,000. And for system users, it will be from 201 to 999. And in the same way for GID, the same it will be the same. It will be the same 1000 to 60,000, and group will be 1201 to 999. So so if you see create home, so this configuration will make sure that the slash home or home and the username will be created. The home directory will be created. If you put no here, then the home directory for that particular user will not be created. You can override this configuration with hyphen m option, which is there in user add, that we will see. And yeah, so these are the important configuration which are there inside your etc login.def files. So this is the default, all your default configuration resides here. So now let's see how can we create users. So in order to create a user, the command is add user, or you can use add user and the username, or the same you can use another command is user add. So they both are the same. You can use any of these command to create a new user. So now let's go ahead and create a user. So user add, and we'll create a user Amit. So your user Amit is already present there, so we have to check another name. So let's take a user add, and you can give ABC. So ABC is the user which we are going to create. So you can see the user has been created. So again we can use add user also, add user and XYZ, and this two users has been created. So now let's check if the user has been created. So we'll do a cat slash etc, and this is the password file where you can go and check. So you will see that ABC user has been created, and this is the UID, and this is the group ID, and this is the home location, and this is the pin bash. And in the same manner, XYZ user has been created. This is the UID, and this is the group ID, and then this is the home location, and this is the bash. So earlier we were not able to create a Amit user because this user already existed. So this is the important configuration file which you should remember, is cat etc password. So let's write it down here, slash etc slash passw2. This is the place where your user details will be there. Which all users are there? Your all users detail will be there inside this user pass in this file. So now we have created two user with the two different command, that is add user and user add. They both are the same. Now in order to give them a password, now you see I've created a user ABC and XYZ. So in order to log in into that user, we have to set a password for them. So the command is PSSW password ABC. So now it will be, you will be changing the password for ABC. So let me give the password. So I've given the password for the user ABC, so I can log in into ABC. So PSSWD is the command to set the password for any particular user. Let me do it for XYZ as well. And so you should give a strong password for a user. So now you can see the password for both the user has been set, ABC and XYZ. So password is the command which will help you to set the password for a particular user which you have created. So now if you want to delete a user, now I don't need that XYZ user account in my system and I need to delete it. So the command will be user del, and you can put hyphen r, and you can give the name XYZ. So you can see now, let's go to the file cap password. You will see that XYZ has been removed. So you can see that XYZ file has been user definition has been removed for this file. So this is how we can delete a user which are there. Now there is a chance that you need to change this UID. You need to set some other number, so which you want, you have decided and your team has decided, and you want to change this UID. So in that case you can do, and the command is user mod and then hyphen small u, and give the number which you want to change. So let me give 2000 and the username ABC. Now if I do a ID ABC, I will be able to see the UID of this user has been changed to 2000 and GID is 1008. So the same information is there inside our cat password file also. So you can see here it has been changed, the UID has been changed to this particular user, to the number which we have provided. And so there may be a scenario in which you want to change, you want to give some comment or description about this user ABC, what this user does. So in that case we have to use the command user mod as well, user mod, and then you have to give a description. So hyphen c, and then you can give a system user, something like that. You can give the comment and then for which user, so ABC. Now if I go to my cat password file, you will see I got the description about this user. So this is the description which I have added for this user, so it will help me to identify what is the use of this particular user. So there may be a chance in which you need to change the username. Now ABC is the username, and there is a requirement in which I need to change the username for that particular user. So now again I will use user mod, and then to change the user I have to use hyphen l, and this is the old name. And then what I want to do, I want to make it PQR. So it will be, first I have to give the new name and then the old name. So now if I go inside my file, you will see the ABC user has been changed to PQR, whatever I have set right now. So this is how you can change your username. So let's just discuss this once more. Do that. Let me just clear this. Let me see what all commands we have used. So we have used the add user, user add, and we also have used PSSWD password to change the password. We also have a user del to delete a user, hyphen r, so that it will remove the home directory as well. And then we have used the command usermod. So there were multiple options with the usermod, which is hyphen small u to change the UID of that user. Then we have another thing, use hyphen c to give the description of that user, so that in etc password file we'll get the description. Hyphen, you can use hyphen s also to change see the shell to change the shell of this particular. So there are multiple parameters which are there. Hyphen d is there to change the home directory. So there are a lot of parameters which you can use. And then the last command which we have used is hyphen l to rename the user. So if but we have to make sure that we give the new name first, new name, and then the old name. So this is the format which you have to remember. So these are the commands which we have discussed right now based on the group. So if you want to get more information about these commands, the best thing is that we can do a man is the manual pages, man and user add. You can do user add. User add, you can see, and it will show you all the options which are present for that man and what all options can you use along with this command. So there are a lot of options which we have used. Now let me just show you with the man user mod. This, so you can see we have used the command hyphen d is for changing the directory, hyphen d is for expiration date, hyphen f inactive, hyphen g is to change the group id, and hyphen l is to change the new login name which we have used. There is hyphen m, hyphen o, hyphen p, hyphen r, hyphen s to change the cell, hyphen u is to change the uid which we have used in our example. And so there are a lot of things which you can get from good information from this particular man pages. So whenever you are giving a exam for RSCL, and then you are allowed to look into this man pages. If you forgot the option which you have to use, then you can use this man pages, and then you can find out the option which you have to use. So now let's move to the next file, next section, which is creation of groups. So in order to create a group, the command is group add. So group add is the command to group create a group. So let me create a group in here. So I've created a group in here. So now in order to see that if that group has been created or not, so again the file is etc group. So you can see the group India has been created here, and the group ID is 1009, and so we can set the group password as well. And then to set that group password is G PASS WT, and the group name you can set the, let me just set it for group. So now if I go inside that file, you will be able to see the password for that particular so it will be not inside this etc groups, it will be inside G shadow. So if you can see the India and the password for that particular group is present inside that group shadow file. In the same way, the password for your users are present inside etc shadow. If you do a shadow, the password for your users are present. So you can see for PQR user, you have set the this is the password, and these are the different password aging things which we have all it will default things which has been set. For Amit user, the password has not been set, so that is why the in decrypt encrypted password is not present there. So these two files are also important to remember when we are working with our group user and group management. So this is how we will change the group password. So now let's create a three user P1. Okay, so I have already created. So let me create a C1, C2, and C3 to verify if the file it has been created. So the etc PSSWD. So you will see C1, C2, C3 has been created. And now let's add these users which we have created to the particular group which we have just now created. The group which we have created is India. So you can use G PSS password hyphen A. If you use this, then you can add only one user at a time, and the group name is India. So you can see adding user C1 to group India. So this user has been added to the group India. Now if you want to add multiple users in a one go, then you have to use capital M, and you can give multiple usernames C2 comma C3 and then the group name. So now these all these three have been added into the group India. Now if you want to see which are the which are how many list of users which exist for this India group, so you can do group mems and hyphen L to list and hyphen G to give the group name. So you can see C2 and C3 are present inside India. So now if you want to delete a user from a group, then you can use the same group password command, and then let's the parameter will be hyphen D and to delete, and let's delete C2. So C2 has been removed from group India, and again to add we can use C1, C2, let's again see C1, C2, C3, all are there present inside this India. So you can add and remove a user using this command. So now in order to delete a group, you can do group delete, and then the group name. And now if we will be able to see, so the group does not exist. So this group has been deleted. So in this section, what all we have learned, let's do a recap. Let me just remove this, and then we'll look into the group. So in this section, we have looked upon how we can create a group. How we can create a group with the command which we have used is group add, and the group name we have to give the group name, and to change the password gpass password and the group name. Then you can add user using gpf password. You have to use hyphen A to add a single user, and then the group name. If you use capital M, you can add multiple users to the group. If you want to delete a user from the group, you have to use hyphen D, and username and with the group. If you want to delete the complete group, then you can use the command group delete and group name. And if you want to see the list of users which are there in that group, you can use the command group mems hyphen l to list and hyphen g. You can give the group name. So you can do multiple things with group mems as well. We will see the man pages. So with using group mems also, you can add and remove a user and add a user in a group. So that can be done. So these are some of the important commands which you should remember on your group basis. So now let's again so what are the different files which we have seen? So different files which we have seen is slash etc slash shadow slash etc slash g shadow slash etc slash password slash etc slash group. So these are some of the very important files which you should remember along with your group and user management. So the default one configuration was in etc slash login dot tefs. So if you make the changes here, all the new users which you create will get the values which is specified here. Shadow is where your passwords are saved for your user. This is for group password and this is for user. This is the place where you can see the users which are created. This is the place you can see the groups which are created. So hope we were able to remember and make use of these commands. Do a practice of all these commands on your local Red Hat or your Linux systems so that you get your hands on with different commands and parameters, because these commands and parameters will be asked in our Red Hat certification. So you should be very much familiar and you should know which parameters to use when. So I hope you will be able to follow. We'll meet in the next class with a new chapter.